Hello there! Today we are going to talk about 9 phrasal verbs with Ouch plus a fun game. I'm Derek, your online English teacher who is Scottish. Bonjour à tous en français. Je suis Derek, ton professeur d'anglais en ligne qui est écossais. Right, so if you are watching this video, I guess you would like to learn more about English, so I encourage you to click on the button subscribe if you want to follow these English lessons weekly. And you can also, if you're French, download my free training, a 2-hour training with tips and advice to become bilingual. It's free. You click down below in the description, click on the link, and everything will be mailed to your mailbox. Right, let's come back to our 9 phrasal verbs with out. We're going to start with put out. Put out means to extinguish. Extinguish. For example, to extinguish a fire. Pick out. Pick out means to choose. Pick out, you choose. Fill out. Fill out means to complete a form, so writing. When you write and you complete a form. Complete a form. Look out. Look out means to take notice or to be vigilant. Take notice. Head out simply means to go or to leave. Not to live, but to leave. Long E. To go or to leave. Turn out has several meanings. First one could be to come, to attend. So people turned out, like they came, they attended a meeting. But it also means to be proven the case. So it became logical, it was revealed. Okay, so that's also for turnout. Workouts has 2 main meanings. Workouts, first meaning could be to end in a good way, so a story that ended, a problem that ended in a good way, it worked out. And also it means to do some sports, so push-ups, pull-ups, weights, to work out. End in a good way, and workout also to do some sports. Find out. So to find out means to discover some information. So when you discover some information, you find out more about something. To figure out means to find a solution. So when you figure out something, you find a solution. So you've got those 9 phrasal verbs. Put out, pick out, fill out, look out, head out, turn out, work out, find out, figure out. And now we're going to channel those words into the fun game. So I guess you know what this fun game is. This fun game is called tick, tack, toe. Or you also have another name. Knots and crosses. Knots and crosses. So what you are going to do now, you can pause the video if you want, but you you can take one of those phrasal verbs, make a sentence and put it in a square or in a box, and of course you need to have a straight line of either knots or either crosses. So let's just make an example, and we'll see if you get it. For example, if I take this box and ID, this is not possible. This is a little bit of French, or an ID, it's also your identity card. And if I say to put out, let's start with put out, and I'll be not. So, for example, the fireman put out the fire. The fireman put out the fire. That'll be correct. Figure out. We've figured out what the problem was. We figured out the problem with this computer. We've figured out. So now I'll be crosses. Pick out. For example, if you play a game and you have the wrong number, you could say, oh my goodness, I've picked out the wrong number. Or if you're making a team, building a team, and you pick out people, and you say, oh my goodness, I've picked out the wrong guy. Picked out, and we can put it, I don't know, here. Fill out. For example, if you want to compete at Britain's Got Talent, you have to fill out a form. You have to fill out a form with your information to fill out. Okay? Look out. It can just be a short sentence, like, look out means watch it, be careful. Look out, you're going to fall. Look out, you're falling. So look out could be an option too. All right. Head out. For example, my family and my wife and my two kids, we are heading out to Scotland in a couple of weeks. We are heading out to Scotland in a couple of weeks. So head out. I guess I am now at crosses. Turn out. You could say people turned out to vote, or it turned out to be true. So turn out has several meanings. Work out. I always work out in the evenings. I always work out on Saturdays. I never work out in the evening. So work out doing sports, or this story worked out well. So it ended in a good way. The second meaning. And we could put it 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3. Oh! And the last one, to find out. We could say, I'm going to find out who you really are. I'm going to find out. I'm going to discover who you really are. And so this one would be the last knot. So this is the game. This is called Tic-Tac-Toe, or it is called Knots and Crosses. I think this one is American, this one is British, but I'm not certainly sure. Here are those 9 phrasal verbs. You can use them. It will, of course, make you more fluent, and you will progress in your fluency and accuracy. And I'm going to wish you a lovely day. You can click on the button to subscribe and leave a comment, and I will gladly reply to your comments as soon as I have some time. Have a beautiful day. Bye-bye. It was Derek, your online language teacher, who is...